Hey everyone, I am back today with another big ginormous coloring book haul. I know you guys love them. I love buying them so that I can color in them and show them to you. So let's just get started. So this one is one that I've already done a flip through for. This is Mickey and Minnie, 100 Images to Inspire Creativity. This is a Disney coloring book. I showed this, I believe, on a stream to you guys as a full flip through of it, and I got this from the publisher for review. I think this one's coming out very soon. I think it's coming out either in September or in October. September or October. It's really a cute little book with lots of Disney posters, so I'm not going to do like a crazy amount of flip-throughs for this because I have a lot, so we're just going to do some, but that is my first one. Okay, the next one is another Chinese coloring book that I ordered from AliExpress. I have one more that I'm waiting on that I have my doubts on if it's going to show up or not, but we will see. But this one I ordered a few weeks ago, maybe like 3 weeks ago. I've had it for a week now. I haven't done anything in it, but this is another one like the other Chinese coloring book that I showed you with just beautiful single-sided images. I think most of them are single-sided, if not all of them. And I just love the pictures in these books. They are so beautiful. The paper, I love this one. This is one of my favorites. And the paper is so soft. I used my Derwent Color Softs on the other one, the Chinese coloring book that I did. I think I did a color and chat with it a while ago, and I can't tell you the names because I don't know what they are, but I really enjoyed working with them. I used my Polychromos in the second picture that I did, also really lovely. I know that you can use watercolor on them. My friend V used watercolor. She shares her pictures with me all the time, which is such a blessing. I love seeing her beautiful work, and we both have these books, and yeah, I just love these. I love everything about them. The images, the paper, the feeling you get working on them, it's just so nice. Like, look at this one. Oh, it is so beautiful. And I really, really love working in these, and I will be doing some more of these very soon. But right now I'm kind of focusing on my autumn / Halloween stuff. But every once in a while I'll sneak in something different just so it can break it up. But isn't that just so beautiful? And the cover has a nice metallic in the writing. I'm gonna have to ask my nail guy, Michael. Shout out to Michael, he watches my videos now. I'll have to ask him what this says. Maybe he'll tell me when I see him the next time, but okay, and I have another one. This one also from AliExpress. Michael, can you tell me what this says? Because I have no idea, but anyway. This is on the same idea, same beautiful paper and same type of images. I think you can find flip throughs of these online on YouTube. If you want a flip through of it, let me know. I'm doing a pretty fair flip through of this for you now. I don't believe in holding them back. Usually the only ones that I do hold back are ones that I've gotten for review because I like to do separate videos of those. But here's a pretty good idea of what is in this book if you're interested in them. Beautiful images. It came with this little booklet here. Obviously, I don't know what it says, but it has something to do with using your watercolors, because this is the Gamzai Tambi watercolor palette, which I do have. I got that for my birthday. So it's telling you about all different techniques and things that you can do, some shading and stuff with your watercolors in these books. And I would like to use my watercolors in these and see how it goes. My friend V just did this one, and hers came out absolutely gorgeous. I do believe she may have used some watercolors in it, I'm not sure, but this is using, I believe, watercolor pencils and then going over it with the water and the water brush. So yeah, you can do a lot with these. I probably would be very light with the water just to test it out and see how it goes, but I love these books to pieces. You guys just have no idea. I love working in them. I love the images. I love everything about them. I'm gushing about these books just because I love them so much and I'm so happy to have them. So like I said, I'll be working in these very soon. I'm not sure if I showed you this in a haul or not. I know I showed it on one of my streams, but anyway, this is a book I got from Thailand. I think the name of it is Magical Tale of Trip and Sasora. I'm not sure, but I got this on Amazon, and it is so cute. I can't even look at this. I can't even take it because it's so cute. I started a picture in here. I haven't finished it, but I started this one. I have to hit the camera. Sorry. I have to go back and finish this one because I really love it. The pages are so smooth and soft. I started with my polychromos on here. It's going to be a little bit of work because they are very soft. They have like zero tooth, but they're really nice pictures. And I'm not going to have any problem putting pencils down in here. They're super, super lovely. I'm sure I could put some watercolor down in this too. It's not really thin or anything. So we'll see what I do in here, but love it, love it, love it. And it came with this cute little bookmark. I don't know what the heck it says, but yeah. So there's that. The next thing I have is this book by Calm Waters Coloring. This is a book of mythology, and what is really cool about it is it has all different artists' interpretations on different things. So I'll show you a little bit here. I got this on Amazon. It is a coloring book from Canada. And what's so cool about it is most of the pictures are in landscape, and they are gorgeous pictures. Like, can you see this? I love the images in here. And what's nice about it is on the back page, it tells you who it's, well, you could put colored by, you put your name and your date, and it tells you on the back page of the image that that is an elf, and it tells you who the artist is. So this is Natalia Meiser from Russia. So I'm not going to do a full flip through of this, but just give you an idea of all of the beautiful, crazy beautiful pages that are in here. They do probably like 10 or 15 images by one artist, and then they move into the next artist. And the next artist has a totally different interpretation and way of drawing it. So this artist, Victor Simas of Republic of Moldova. I don't know what his name is or whatever, but his way of drawing is not exactly something that I would like to color as much, but that's just me. I like Natalia's pictures. And then once we get past Victor's, we go back into the dark line art. And this is Xavi Renee Pascual of Spain. So then we have some more things. And this is all stuff from mythology. And just really super cute. So I really like this book. I haven't gotten a chance to work in it just yet, but I will be working in it very soon. And it's like sort of like a grayscale book. Okay, the next one that I have for you is one that I have done a picture. I have posted on the Facebook and Instagram pages. This is Girl Power, and this is by Hatchet Heroes. I got this on Amazon UK. I didn't have any problem getting it. Actually, it came really fast. The only problem with this book that I have is that the pages have fallen out. So if that doesn't matter to you, then you won't have a problem. But as you can see here, they're just coming right out of here. And this is the pages that have already fallen out. So it is glued in, and that is the reason it's not terribly wonderfully glued into the top. But honestly, I'm not really, I don't care about it that much. I can put them in a folder, and they are all true Disney images, which, you know, for me, it's like something that I can bypass them falling out. A lot of people take their pictures out of their books anyway and put them in a binder, so it probably wouldn't even matter. I did work in a page in here, and I will show it to you. I've only been using my pencils lately. I haven't been using any watercolor. No particular reason why. I've just been into my pencils. But I used my polychromos on this, and I will show you now that I have it on video. Let's see if we can do this without, like, destroying the book. Probably not. It is very sparkly. I don't know if you can see all the stars, and her wings are super, super sparkly. Let's see. Can you see it without sticking the light right in there? Yeah. And then there's stickles on all of the little flowers, and then there's Wink of Stella on her wings and on the sign. So this is really nice paper. You could definitely use watercolor. It's single-sided. It's on the thinner side, but I don't see it having a problem holding water. Just don't use too much. And if you're not going to tear it out and you're going to use it like a pad or whatever, just make sure to put some paper on the other side so you don't ruin your following image. But other than that, gorgeous, gorgeous pictures. You do have your repeating patterns, of course, but for the most part, it's not repeating patterns. It's just a lot of different heroines from Disney movies. So there is that one. The next one is one that you guys have probably seen me work in. This is a Daisy O coloring book. I got this on Amazon. It's called Cityscape, and I got it because I wanted the picture that I worked on in here first. This is, everyone told me it's Bavaria, not Germany, but you know what? It's your coloring book, and it can be anything that you want it to be. So this is a little Oktoberfest, an ode to Oktoberfest, and I absolutely love it. I did the flowers and the colors of the German flag, and they're having some beer and some wieners and some pretzels. So yeah, and I really, really enjoyed working on this book. I was like, all the time, I was just so happy with like touching and looking at this book. It has some gorgeous, gorgeous pictures in it from all, you know, places all over the world. And they're really pleasant and nice to color. Look at Holland. It's got windmills, pretty flowers, bikes, cows, all kinds of fun stuff there. And there's just all different stuff from all over. Some pages are a double page spread, some are just single. Here we have like the UK and London, all that kind of stuff. Really a really beautiful, fun book. Just as a fun note here, when I was looking through this, Frank and I were, he was looking at it with me, and I was like, oh my god, look at the kangaroos, because I love kangaroos. And he was calling them wallabies, and I didn't know that there was a difference between wallabies and kangaroos, but he's like, have you ever seen a kangaroo fight? And we spent the next 25 minutes watching kangaroo fights on YouTube and cracking up, because I had no idea that they can like kick you into next week. So yeah, that's what Frank and I do on a fun Friday night. But anyway, so I'm really loving this book. The paper, the pages, the art, super, super in love with it. I love these. You guys know I've been into my Asian coloring pages a lot lately. So love this book, and I highly, highly recommend this. And since I highly, highly recommend it, I bought the Wonderland Forest. I also got this from Amazon. Now, these came with little sets of pencils, which are just like 12 colored pencils. They're just really hard, cheap pencils. So I just put those to the side. Emilio someday can have them if he ever wants to use them. He's been into my twistable crayons. I bought a pack of twistable crayons for the car, and I don't really like them, but I gave them to him, and he absolutely loves them. The kid uses them every single day now. He constantly wants to color. He's so happy with them. They're perfect for his little hands, and he's just been using them. He's even asked to color in my books. That's how much he loves them. But I really wanted this one because I love the other one so very much. And this one has some beautiful pictures of just animals, birds, iguanas, bears, porcupines, you name it, owls. Beautiful, beautiful book, and I love these so much. I haven't done anything in this book just yet, but I will be very soon. Okay, the next one is one that I ordered from Etsy. This is Gardens and Goddesses by Mitzi Sadoruff. I'm not sure how to pronounce her last name. I'm sure I pronounced that wrong. But I did show this a little bit on Instagram. Here is her information. You can find her Etsy store at, can you see that? www.aurorawings.etsy.com. Mitzi Sadoruff. Yeah, so she included this really nice art card in here for me. Very beautiful. I've spoken with her. She is a lovely, lovely lady. And this book she sells out of regularly. So once I saw it, I really, really wanted this one. And this has just beautiful pictures of all different kinds of women, fairies, mermaids, all that kind of stuff. It's a really nice paper, kind of like Friends of Nature. It's a little on the thicker side, not terribly thick. You could use watercolor, just be careful, but it does have a slight gloss to it. So I did use watercolor on the Friends of Nature, so if I used it on there, I'm sure it would be fine using it on here as well. So beautiful book, and you can get that on Etsy. Okay, I was enabled by Anne Hatfield on this one. If you guys have not seen her color and chat, she just did her very first color and chat with this book. She's doing a color along. I'm not part of the color along, but I did want the book because I really like how the images look. They are super cute. This is a Deborah Muller book. And it's just all Halloween stuff, and Anne used her markers on it, and it came out really, really beautiful. And I said, you know what, I want to give that a try, so I'm going to try using my markers on it. I have the Bic Market, she did this picture, I know for sure. She did the Bic Market marking markers. Yes. And I do have those, but mine are all dried out. This was the picture she did for her Carl Lorelum. Mine are all dried out. I've had them for probably 7 or 8 years. So I'm not going to probably replace those. I'm just going to use my Sharpies and my Crayola Super Tips and see what I can do. But this is just a really, really cute little book. And I want to see, you know, what pictures I can color in it for the Halloween season. Okay, the next one is a fairy tale coloring book. And this is by Tomoko Toshiro. I found this at Hobby Lobby, my very first trip to a Hobby Lobby. They just opened one here on Long Island, and we took a trip there this past weekend, and they had a plethora of coloring books. So I picked up this one. I thought it was really, really cute. It's got a lot of very intricate details in it, but I don't care. I liked it. There was just something about it that really, as I say, tickled my pickle, and I just wanted to have it. So this was my little find from Hobby Lobby, and I'm looking forward to doing some pictures in this. I probably won't get to this until the new year, and so, unless something strikes my fancy and I want to just jump into it, but it's just really a beautiful book, and I like it a lot. Okay, the next one is one that I received for review. This is coming out next Tuesday, September 19th, which is my anniversary. So there's a lot of books and movies coming out. I already did a full flip through on this one, so I'm not going to flip through this yet. I'm not going to flip through it again, but I am going to be working on it this week. I'm going to pick a picture and I'm going to do some work on it so that you guys can see what I can do with it, you know, and see how I make it my own. But I know so many of you have pre-ordered it now that I've done the flip through of it, and I'm so happy to hear that. I hope that you guys like this as much as I do. I think no matter what, it is a gorgeous book, even just to have the art on the side. And I will report back to you after I have worked in it. And I'm not sure what picture I'm going to do yet, but like I said, I will report back. All right, the next one is one that I've just completed a picture from. I just showed this one to you guys. This is from Holland with Love by Maja Vandenberg. And I received this, I bought this from her. I got this on Etsy. I love this book, you guys. It is a beautiful hardcover. I've been in touch with her, and she is such a sweet person. She subscribed to my channel. She is following me on Instagram. She liked my picture. I just finished this picture. It is lovely, lovely paper. I use my Polychromos on this. It has Wink of Stella. It has stickles on it. I think you can see them. I had so much fun working on this, like, sweet little page. I put on Ocean's 13 on Saturday night. Frank fell asleep, and I just worked on this. I was having a lot of trouble sleeping on Friday and Saturday. Actually, I didn't go to bed till 4 o'clock in the morning both days because Hurricane Irma was about to hit Florida. And both my mother-in-law and our best friends live down there, both in the path. Basically, anybody in Florida was in the path. Of course, our dear Mona here was also in the path. Beth, so many of you guys, and I was really worried about all of you, and I had a lot of trouble sleeping. So what I did was I just worked on this cute little picture, and it did take me 2 days to work on it, but I loved it. I'm so excited to work on some more of this book. It's just gorgeous. It's such a beautiful book. It's all original art by herself. And she also included in the back these little things. Now, she told me what they mean, and now I forgot. But one of them is work in progress. The other one is, one of them is proud, so I think it might be that one. One of them might be colored by, and I have to look, and I'll put it down in the description below if I can remember. But they're all different things that you can color yourself, and you can put, there's a little fly in here, so just ignore that. Why in my videos does this crap happen? Anyway, you can color these little things and use them as little like placeholders for your pictures if you wanted to put them in your pictures when you upload to Instagram or whatever. So that's nice. And then you have these cute little postcards in the back that you can color. So it's like a replica of the one that I did, which is a stamp. And then you can use those for, you can use them for anything you want. You don't have to use them for postcards, but you can if you want to. And then you have a test page in the back. And then you get this really nice little card that she sent to me for ordering the book. And like I said, she's a really lovely lady. I got this super fast, although it did get lost at the post office, and I had to go and hunt it down. And basically, tell them that they were not going to lose me until they found my book. I was going to be a regular friend of theirs and calling them and visiting them all the time. And magically, it showed up that afternoon. So there you go. But the pages are also perforated if you wanted to take them out and frame them or give them to somebody or whatever. But I saw this book on Katrine's channel. She actually worked on this page, that's what just reminded me of it. I saw this, she did a stream from this on Instagram a few times, and I am also subscribed to her channel. I love watching her coloring, and her channel name is Always Coloring, and that's how you can find her, also on Instagram. And she had this book, I believe she got this from the artist for a review, and I just fell in love with it. So that is how I found it, and that is why I got it. Okay, the next few books are Creative Haven books, which I got really cheap. These books I got on Amazon, and I wanted them for the holiday season. I thought the pictures were really cute, so this is an old-fashioned Christmas. I got the winter scenes because I love the autumn scenes so very much, so I picked up the winter scenes too. This is stuff you guys have all seen already, so I don't need to do an in-depth talking or flip through. And then I got this one, which I've had on my list for a very long time, and then I saw Anne Hatfield got it, and she did a flip through of it. And once I finally got to see what the pictures actually look like on the inside, I was like, yes, okay, I need this. Because even if I don't color these all that much, I love all of these movies. Like, no joke, I've seen all of these movies and I freaking love them. So it's got The Wizard of Oz, it's got It's Terrific, Citizen Kane. Yeah, Citizen Kane was pretty terrific. Stagecoach, Gone with the Wind. I mean, this screams me. This is such a good movie. Have you guys seen It Happen One Night? If you haven't seen it, please do yourself a favor and find this movie. You can get it for really cheap in like the stores and stuff. It's got Clark Gable in one of his first like breakout roles as a comedian. It's such a great movie. Okay, I need to stop. But anyway, I love this book. So here are the original posters if you wanted to replicate them. If you don't, do whatever you want to do. If you don't even want to color it and you just want the pictures, then do that. And I may just do that. I don't know. I haven't decided, but I love everything in here. Even has Breakfast with Tiffany. So how can you go wrong? And my father's favorite movie of all time, It's a Wonderful Life. You cannot go wrong. I've seen all of these movies. I love them. They're all good. Yes, 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 and yes. Okay, I know this is taking forever, but I got a lot of stuff, guys, and I got more stuff on the way, so I never disappoint with my book hauls, right? So this is Archie's coloring book. I don't remember where I heard about this first, but I heard about it, and we actually know one of the illustrators. So Frank got in touch with him, and I got this book from them, and they signed it for me. So I thought that was really, really cool. A few of the people that were involved with the publication of this actually signed it, and I am so excited to have this. I don't know that I'm going to color in it. We'll see. I think I might just keep it very nice so that nothing happens to it. I might just put it in a little sleeve because it's signed and stuff. We'll see. I'm not sure what to do with it yet, but I love the book, and I think it's like super cool that several of the people that were involved with publishing it signed it for us. Okay, we're getting down to the end. Alright, another thing that I got from AliExpress was this one. It's called Love Secret. This is another Chinese coloring book, and this is a thick book, you guys. Like, look at how thick that is. It's got lovely thick pages, and it's got super cute images. Just this kind of thing that I love to color. Isn't that adorable? Of course, I don't know what it says on the other side here. Look, Anne, it's a peacock. But I loved the pictures, and it's all about different people being in love, animals being in love, all just kinds of things about love. And I'm a sucker for anything with love and hearts and stuff like that. So I had to have this book, and I love it. Lack of a better phrase, I love it. And it's going to be really nice to color during the Valentine's season. Oh, it even came with this cute little postcard. I didn't even see that until just now. But isn't this super, super cute? Look at the fish! Oh, I love it. Love it! Okay, and then the next thing I have is the Mermaids in Paradise coloring book. I have already showed this to you guys. It's coming out, I think, today, the 12th. And this is by Denise Klett, I don't know. This is the picture that I did. I did a full flip through of this one on my stream, and I colored this with you guys, and it's very, very stickly and beautiful, and I'm very happy with these stickles and shine. So I want to say Prismacolors on this one, but maybe it was Polychromos, not sure. And I used chalk in the background. I had some neon orange and yellow, and I used that for the sky. And the pictures are so adorably cute in this book. I just absolutely love it. So, yeah, I hope you guys get this book, because I'd really like to see some other people do some adorable finishes from this book. I'm going to be working on this book some more. I don't care the summer's over. It's too cute not to work in, so I am in love with that book. Okay, the very last one I have for you is The Wizard of Oz coloring book. Now, where did I find this? Oh, yeah, Target. It was the only one that was there. You guys know I have a love affair with The Wizard of Oz. It's my favorite movie of all time, and I had to have it. So it's really, really cute. I picked this book up because we were taking a break sitting in the car, and I wanted something to do. And of course, I wanted it because it was Wizard of Oz. But I also picked up some crayons and some twistable pencils to keep in the car. So I really didn't get much of a chance to work on it. I worked on something in the back a little bit, but I had to have it because it's Wizard of Oz. So, you know, just got to add it to the collection. So that is everything. That is a lot that I had for you in this video, and it's a long video, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. I will have some more coming in. I'm going to be doing another color in chat really soon. Hopefully I'll be able to stream on Thursdays as I have been. I'm now streaming on YouTube, for those of you guys that were wondering where I am streaming these days. I'm doing the YouTube thing. It seems to be working out well. And I'm going to have another haul for you coming up quite soon. I'm waiting for Tenderful Endearments, or whatever the new Clara Markova book is. That is the story. Like I said, I have several more things coming in that I'll show you in another haul. And I'm going to be doing my finishes, my video of my finishes very soon. And then very soon we're going to be starting our Halloween color along. So there are a lot of fun things coming up, and I'm looking forward to all of them. I hope you guys are too. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I will see you in my next video.